Hello, gorgeous ones. Lou Anne here, just checking I'm live. Everyone's home in Melbourne, hogging all the internet. Yes, they are. Awesome. So I look like I'm live here. How are you all? Happy Monday. Coming in this afternoon. I purposely stayed off social media this morning. I am working on a little project that I hope you all like coming up soon. But I seem to find that if I don't hop on social media first thing on, especially on a Monday or in the morning, then I can clear out some of the projects that I have. And then this afternoon, I'm on and I can share and then all as well. Hey Bernadette, good to see you. Yes, I changed phones because like I said, internet. So today, if you're watching this, if you're new, I mean, obviously, if you're in the Goddess Inner Circle, where I actually go live, this is live in here, you're the first to see this, you will know that I choose three cards, and I've actually got two, working with two decks today, two different ones, and they are related to your purpose, your presence, and your profit. Whether you own a business, if you're a spiritual entrepreneur, these are for you. If you don't, and you have a hobby or it's just in your life, you can still use those messages for you or for your work. So yeah, good to see you, Bernadette. So today I am using the, have not brought these out for a long time, and I will tell you why. The Maori Oracle, by the beautiful PA Manal. She's no longer with us on the planet. She's been passed over many years ago, but this is her awesome Maori Oracle deck, and I have not used it for a while because I had some on YouTube, and some of the words, some of the Maori words I mispronounced, and then there was a negative comment on there, sometimes I can even get affected by that, and it was like, oh my goodness, you didn't say that right, and da da da, and I went, right, let's just pack those away for a little while. Practice my Maori, since I am a Maori, and then we'll bring them out again. But hey, it was a great exercise in criticism, like how you take that on. And there's so many amazing comments on there, and then I focus on one. It's like, okay, we'll just put that here. But anyway, they're out to play now. I'm over it. And the other one I have is my own Oracle deck, and I've reprinted these in a different format now. They're red, but this is one of the oldest. If you got one of the original decks, this is what they look like, and they're just slightly bigger. So I thought it's time to bring these out again, because the beautiful Jo Worthy, so pop over and see her group, the Worthy Goddess group community, and she does a monthly or weekly astrology reading for everybody, what's happening for the rest of the week. And she actually used my cards this week, which is really sweet of her, and I love that. So go over there, she just uses different people's, and it's in this group too. I asked her to put it in there for us. So enough of that blah blah. Okay, so I'm going to share. I have three cards. The first, you can choose all three, or you can just go, okay, one, two, or three. First is purpose, presence, and profit. So as I get a text message, can you please prioritize my phone for the internet from my son? Okay, we'll just take a little breath. And how are you going? Yeah, how are you going? Especially if you're in Melbourne. The energy is a little bit heavier down here, but yeah, I'm doing my best to uplift it. So that's what I've been working on actually. I want to share something this week when I get it finished. So checking in. So our first card is for the word purpose. Now we have two here. I'm going to read this actually. The first card, let me get this right, is Tawira, and it's a beautiful star. Look at that gorgeous star there, Tawira. And Tawira means, it's actually the morning star. And the message that it's giving us is it's time for action. The time for action is now. So this is relating to purpose. The time to get into your purpose is now. And of course, I'm always going to say that. But there are some times where it's not the right time to fully launch something. But this card, if you chose this one, and if you're watching this now, it's now. So when a new building is blessed, so we bless our buildings in New Zealand, or a ceremony is opened, it is always done with the blessing of the morning star, the Tauira. It has been this way for 1,000 years. It is the star for active beginnings. In the old days, the appearance of the Tauira was the guiding light by which an expedition would begin, as well as a signal to attack. So of course we were warriors. We were definitely Maori warriors, but this is a signal. So this is the sign you've been waiting for, right? To step into your purpose even more. And this, to back that up, we actually have in my oracle deck, the goddess on purpose oracle deck, is Pedestal. Now, interestingly enough, right, Pedestal is spelt wrong. Pedestal is spelt wrong. I published not hundreds of these oracle decks, but quite a few, and it was wrong. And until somebody actually, and it being proofread like many, many times, but sometimes when you look at something over and over again, it's like when you're actually writing your book and you're reading it and you still can't pick up that misspelt word. Anyway, this was spelt wrong. And why I'm saying this story is because even though it was spelt wrong, it still went out. Even though it still hasn't been, I'm actually never going to correct it. I'm never going to correct this card when these get printed again. I think it's there for a reason, just to show you how imperfect action can still be perfect. So this is what it means to be on a pedestal. And the normal reason that someone's coming in the door there is putting yourself, like we can sometimes look at other people and, you know, mentors or people who have done something and that you want to do, and you kind of look at, I think we're back. Okay, we're back. So you kind of look at them and you raise them above yourself. Now when this card comes up again for your purpose, it's to remind yourself to put yourself beside them, not them above you. Now of course there's going to be things that a mentor or a coach or a parent or somebody is going to know a bit more about that, but that's okay. That you will learn that they are there to mentor you. But sometimes it can be detrimental because you think you can never reach that pinnacle, right? But this is saying, this is the sign that you've been waiting for, that you are about to step into that purpose. And I just want to read a little bit about this as well. I wrote the book, but I can't sometimes. So, okay, yes, it's actually more about the self-love in you, loving yourself enough to put yourself on the pedestal and make your purpose the center of your life here. Yeah, the champion of your own life, and know that it's time. Okay, hey Michelle, good to see you. Oh, I must have you in here for using one of your beautiful oracles that you've created too. Okay, so that was the purpose one. Now we are going to the presence. So in the middle, presence, purpose, presence, profit. So in the Maori oracle, we have the beautiful tui. Now look at the tui here, it's got this beautiful plume underneath, and now this card relates to presence. And when I say presence, I mean magnetic presence. If you have a business, how you're attracting your clients into you, how you're attracting people that you can support and you can help with your beautiful products. And having been centered in your presence, how you talk, how you show up, you know, are you leaking your energy out everywhere, or is it too closed in? All that kind of stuff. It's just being solid. But the tui, I'm going to read the piece out for the tui. I know how to say that, it's easy. So the tui, beautiful word, is a native parson bird, and it means humility. Each has their own way. So thinking of presence, and the tui is called koko in the South Island of New Zealand, which means a clever speaker or singer, right? So to be a speaker or singer, you have to have a certain presence. Whoever watched The Voice, right? You will see that there's ones there that they just had something about them that they were comfortable. And then, you know, it's a, it, it can be learnt. It can be learnt, definitely. So it is especially treasured for its beautiful song. It has this, oh my goodness, it's like in ancient times, and was kept by the royalty, the distinguished families. So you'll see the flourish of white feathers, which is a mark of maturity. When they have it, it's a mark of purity. For despite his beautiful song and plumage, the tui is not an immodest bird. He understands that to be fortunate does not make one better. And while others may not sing and talk with his beautiful song, it does not mean their ways are less important. Oh, isn't that gorgeous? So, to me, we all have our own gifts. We all have our own special presence. And again, it kind of comes to the pedestal one. Your presence is different to another person's presence. You will magnetize people. You know, I'm sure I put people off every day, the way that I talk or the way that I am, but some people love that, right? And it's actually better for you to polarize them. They'll either love you or they won't. And I don't mean to say hate you, it's not about that. It's like, you cannot be this bland person in the middle, right? Presence, you cannot be for everybody. And once we get over that, then you can actually know who your people are, who your tribe is. Like, this goddess in a circle is not for everybody. And that doesn't mean it's bad or it's worse. It's just not, right? So this tui is a beautiful message for that presence. You will attract the people that you need. Hey, Marianne, awesome to see you. Hey, Michelle. And on the goddess in a circle, the goddess oracle, Pounce. And I just remember when I wrote this, I was just sitting down channeling this, and I'm like, oh, Pounce feels like, you know, that movie, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. And it's like, because it's the presence card, it means you are ready to pounce. You are ready to launch. Don't launch at people. It's just, you are ready to show up and shine. Yeah. This is so relevant today. Thank you, Marianne. Awesome. Now, which one was that? So it says, crouching tiger, ready to pounce, you have been like a magnet, attracting opportunities to you. So opportunities are there for all of us, right? And the universe loves speed. So grab them, claim them, take them. Now is the time, pounce on them. So you've got the beautiful tui and you've got the pounce. Okay, so that was the presence. Now going into our profit, the abundance, and the card, the Maori Oracle card is a beautiful chat with my mum this morning, actually, in New Zealand, and she kind of reminded me, like, nothing's changed, right? They're back on going to restaurants and doing all that. I'm very happy for her, and yeah, she was very excited. So hey, mum, if you're watching this, it was great to chat to you. So this is about change, right? So this is the profit card, abundance, money, honey, and it's called the kawakawa. It's a New Zealand pepper tree. You can see the plant there. And the kawakawa is actually used for cleansing and clearing of the ways, both in a physical and spiritual sense. It is extremely valuable. It's a medicinal plant, and it is said that where the kawakawa grows, a family will be well. So in the past, the twigs were used for tangis, which is funerals, to lift tapus, to lift curses and that kind of thing, and used in many, many ceremonies. So I wonder if you can drink that as a tea. Yeah. So today it's often waved by the women at any event and when they porphyry. So a porphyry, hope I'm saying this wrong, porphyry, is when, if you're at a marae, which is the meeting house, they welcome you on, you know, they sing you on, they call you on to the sacred land. So again, you know, profit is sacred, money is sacred, it's a calling, and it's woven. Yeah, you can go, yeah. And when the kawakawa is worn, yeah, bye darling, it helps both the living and the people who have, you know, moved on to heal and move on. So when it comes to profit, change. To me, it feels like change. If this is your card, if this is, it feels like change is needed in the way you look at profit, the way you look at abundance. Is there something that is kind of holding you back? Again, are you charging enough? Sacredness. It's, do you hold your money or your abundance and as sacred? And when you spend it, are you spending it in a way that's nurturing yourself, nurturing, investing in yourself? Can you actually invest in yourself, right? So what you give out comes back tenfold, right? And buying somebody else's service, you help them and then they spread that and then you get helped as well, and then we buy. So that, I don't know where that's coming from, but that's just what it is. Just keep, be sacred with your money. Look after it, and not to hold on to it, but not to waste it. That's what that is. And then Poor is the card for the Goddess Oracle. Poor. And she is pouring all, actually both. Funny that, Marianne. Both, right? So on the sacredness of your money, it says, pour all your love on the situation before you now. It will come back tenfold. Open the floodgates and express. Now, straight up to me, I'm just going to go with this. Sometimes when I see this come up for people, it's poor and it's about money, it's about profit. Pour your love on the situation. Maybe somebody hasn't paid you, right? Maybe you haven't asked for the money, or you've kind of let things slip. I mean, it's tax time, isn't it? We're kind of getting all those Mercury finger hand analysis systems in place, looking after your money, making sure your resources are held. And when I see this, when it says pour the love on the situation, it's like if you need to get some things in order. It's kind of quite clean to me. It's cleaning your house, cleaning the money house or something. Whoever's got astrology, what's the house of with the money in it? But that's what's coming out for me when I say this, right? So charge enough, look after your finances, get that place in order. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the sacredness of it. So I will put a picture up here. How does that relate? I'm not seeing any more comments here, but yeah, does that make sense to you? And thank you for hanging in here. So I will put that up and send it out. If you're on the email list, you know, you can go over, and if you're not, these get sent out to the email list as well, luannemarine.com. And Marianne, you need to get things in order. Don't we all, love? Don't we all? But again, small steps. Yeah. Yeah. It just feels better. Again, the universe, you know, it loves decluttering. It loves space to come in. So those opportunities. So there we have it. Pedestal, Pounce and Pour. Right, and then we have the Morning Star, Tawara, the Tui, the Call, and the Kawakawa, sacredness. Yeah. All right, beautiful ones. Mwah. See you next week. Again, look out. I've got something new coming this week with the current climate. Yeah, it's called Silver Linings. I just wanted to create a small little course for you to give you some hope back. I think it's to give me some hope back. Some hope that things are going to be okay, because they are. Yeah, we just have to stick together, stay and keep communicating with each other, keep supporting each other, and I'm really, really grateful for this group. Okay, lots of love. Yes, Michelle, makes sense. Awesome. Okay, bye for now.